Hello everyone, welcome to WebSense Pro. I'm your host Bilal Nasir with a new video, and in today's video I'm going to show you guys how you can set up conditional visibility in your Elementor sections and widgets. So Elementor is a really cool and famous drag and drop builder for WordPress, but it's lacking a really important feature, which is to set up conditional visibility for the elements and sections. So whether if you take the pro version, it's lacking that feature. It doesn't have the conditional visibility option. Today I'm going to show you guys how you can set up that using a free plugin. So one case scenario which we'll be discussing is that, for example, if you have that my account button, if you are selling products or you are building a WooCommerce website and you have that my account button, how you can set that up in a way that it will show up to only logged in user, and when the guest is visiting the website in a logged out mode, it will just say login. And we will also be showing how you can display specific sections on template only on specific products. And there are many other conditions which we can set up using that free plugin. So if you want to learn, stick to the video. Don't forget to like, share, and comment to the video below. And let's get into the back end of our WordPress store. Okay guys, so that's our website which is built using Elementor and Elementor Pro. It's our clothing store, and we will set up conditional visibility for this my account thing. So when someone visit it on logged out mode, it will show login, not my account. So if I check it now on incognito window, which is like logged out mode of the website, we can still see the my account button. Right, and similarly we can see that when we are in logged in mode. What we're gonna do, we'll set it up in a way that it will show my account to only logged in users, and to logged out user it will say login. So when someone click on that, it will show the login screen. Okay, now in order to do that, we will install a plugin called Dynamic Visibility for Elementor. That's the plugin. So that's the free plugin which we'll be using to achieve that feature. And now let's get into the dashboard and install the plugin. So that's our WordPress dashboard, and I'm gonna click on plugins and then add new. And from there, I can search dynamic visibility for Elementor. I can also download the plugin from here and upload it from this option, and also search it from here and install it, whatever way you like the most. And now click on install now. After installing, activate the plugin. Once this plugin is activated, you will see option of visibility on Elementor backend. So in order to hide it to logged out user, what I'm gonna do, I'll edit my header template, which is here. So I'm going to open it in a new window. Okay guys, so I'm on my header template. And now when I click on this icon, you can see that we have an additional option which says visibility. So it's not a built-in feature. It's added after the installation of the plugin which we installed. Okay, now click on that. And now we will enable this feature. And we will set the display mode. Now it says show. We are adding a condition for it to show only to logged in users. Now we have multiple triggers. We will delete all the triggers and leave just user and roles, because we need to trigger it based on the user role. Now I'm going to delete all the remaining triggers, and now we have only user and roles, right? Expand the dropdown, and now I'm going to add the user roles here. It should show to administrator, obviously. and it should show to editor. It should also show to shop manager. And it will also show to customer. So that's the role which is for our customer. So whoever will buy the product will be able to log in and will be able to see this My Account, right? And now when we hit update, and now if we go to incognito window and hit refresh, you can see that it's not visible anymore. So it's only visible to logged in users. Right? Now we need to show login to the logged out mode users or the guest user. In order to do that, I'm just going to duplicate the icon, go to my visibility section, and in display mode we leave as it is, and in user and role I'm going to change it to visitor. So that's the role for non-logged in users. Sorry, visitor. Yep, that's it. Click on that, and now from my account I'll rename it to login. So instead of my account it should say login. So currently both of this my account and login is going to my account page. That's the built-in page of WooCommerce, and it automatically detects the login and logged out user, and to logged in user it shows the account history and order history, and to non-logged in user, to the visitor of the website, it will just show the login screen. So that's the default page of WooCommerce, which will come when you install WooCommerce and install the pages of WooCommerce by default. Okay, now hit update. And now when I go to incognito window and hit refresh, you can see that we have this login button showing up, and when I click on that, it takes me to the My Account page and asks me to log in. And when you log in, it will show you the account and order history, just like to the login users who visit the My Account page. So that's how it's going to show to the login user, where they'll be able to see their orders, addresses, account details, and etc., etc. Again, this is a default WooCommerce page, and it will come when you install the WooCommerce plugin, which is a really big e-commerce plugin of the WordPress. If you don't know about it, just Google it out. It's a really great plugin to set up your website in WooCommerce. It works with Elementor and all of the big plugins. Okay, so that's how we set up the visibility based on login user or logged out user. We can also set up visibility on multiple conditions. So if you go to this visibility section, we have many other options, many other triggers. Like if I create a new menu, so let's duplicate this one. And here we have the visibility, just on the visibility option. And these are all of the triggers which we have. So we can display this menu based on the post and page visited by a user. So for example, if you want to display a special menu to a specific page, you can simply do that from here. You can simply select the post type, select page, select pages from here, And after you select the pages, you can search for the pages. For example, these are the pages. So if I want this menu to be displayed only on home page, I can select this. And it will only be visible to the home page. Similarly, we have multiple conditions in this plugin. We can set it up based on device and browser. So if a person is using Chrome browser and another person is using a Safari browser, we can set up that as well. We can select the trigger as per date and time if we want to display the menu on a specific time. For example, if you are running a holiday campaign and if you have an announcement bar which you just want to display based on the dates of those holidays, you can simply set up that trigger as well. You can set up the geo-targeting trigger. You can set up the multiple other triggers which we have. So it's a huge plugin with a lot of settings available. Not possible to cover up in one single video. So this video was just about to how to set up my account and login button and display the section depending on specific page or post. And if you want to learn more about this plugin, or if you want to learn more about WordPress, Elementor, and anything else related to web design and development, do let me know in the comments below. Until next video, have a great day.